Hello there, a very good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Joining us today from Gresham House, it's the CEO, Tony Dalwood, and the Chief Financial Officer as well, Kevin Acton. Great to see you both. How are you?
Very well. Good to see you again.
Good. Excellent. So let's get stuck in here and maybe start with Tony telling us about the key takeaways from the results that you've announced this morning.
Great to be here. Thanks very much, Katie. Yes, we had a very, very good year last year at Gresham House here. The team has performed exceptionally well, hitting all their goals and actually exceeding them in many respects. And over the next couple of minutes, we'll show you some financial as well as some strategics that we've achieved. And there's a long way to go on our journey. We've been 7 years into it now as a team, but there's still a long way to go and a lot more to achieve. Last year, our assets grew by 65% to 6.5 billion sterling. Importantly, within that, we grew 50% organically, which is a very key aspect that we'd like to focus on. We have achieved those sorts of numbers historically, and obviously we have ambitions going forward. Other parts of our strategy as well was to enhance margins, to enhance our revenues and operating profit lines in absolute terms. We've done that. And part of that also was our strategic goal to increase our return on capital employed. And today we've announced that we are increasing our target for return on capital employed and actually achieved a 34% return on capital last year, a significant uptick from the previous years. I've mentioned our five-year goals. They are under our GH25 objectives. They're both strategic and financial, but one of them that we've actually inserted today is to insert a dividend policy. We have a target now over the next 3 years or so to hit a 3x cover number. And that's significant as it leads to today's announcement that we're increasing our dividend by 67% to 10 pence per share. So we're pleased where we position that front as well.
All right. Okay. Tony, you've gone through a few of the reasons really for this performance, but what would you say is the main driver from what you've announced today?
We've had a lot of organic growth from clients wanting to put their money in some of our investment strategies, particularly the fact that there's sustainability characteristics within them. The ESG aspects are growing. We have a lot of our products offer some of those characteristics that people are after in the real assets and particularly the private assets world as well. In addition to that, we've got a playbook of enhancing shareholder value through acquisitions. And last year, we established our international footprint by acquiring a business called Appian to establish Gresham House Ireland, taking us into Europe. And in addition to that, we added to our VCT and private equity platform through the acquisition of Mobeus. And so we're very well positioned to continue growth in all those other dimensions internationally, as well as within the private assets and private equity area. And overseas, where we acquired a significant forestry asset on behalf of a client as we move into international territories as well. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, we've invested in our business. We want to scale this business well beyond the 6.5 billion we have today. We increased our target in GH25 at the end of last year to over £8 billion, and we want to go well beyond that in due course. Hence, we've invested in talent during the last year or so as well.
All right. Well, we'll talk about that further, but we are going to bring Kevin in just now because maybe you can give us a bit more detail on your fundraising performance during the year.
Yeah, absolutely, Katie. Thank you. So we've had an outstanding performance in the last year from a fundraising perspective. We had net inflows of 1.2 billion, which compares to 0.4 billion from the prior year. And the pleasing thing is that that's come from right across the business. So we've had across our strategic equity division, we raised over 200 million in both our open-ended funds through net flows as well as fundraisers for our BCT business. With Grid, our battery storage fund, we raised another 100 million this year, proving that that's a concept which is really getting traction now with people looking to invest in that particular area of renewables. On the forestry side of things, we launched a new forestry growth and sustainability fund, again, closing at just over 200 million. And finally, which is good news, we raised our strategic infrastructure fund, British BSIF II, our second LP, which raised a further 150 million. So proving the concept from our first fund that we can actually raise money and develop there. So what's great is we're seeing that's also adding to diversification across our client distribution channels and really showing that the investment that we put in the distribution team is starting to pay off.
All right. And the group also made some key acquisitions in 2021, Kevin. What was the strategic rationale, would you say, for these?
Great question. So we acquired a business called Appian, which we signed in June last year. Appian Asset Management is an EU-based AFIM, so a manager, and gives us the ability, a real foothold in Europe post-Brexit, to be able to expand our business internationally. We've been working very hard with that team now, so we've we've fully integrated the business now within the Gresham House family. And moving on from that, we're delighted to announce today that actually we're working with Burlington. So we're looking to acquire the Burlington business, where we have a joint venture existing over a commercial property fund, which we also have based in Ireland as well. So good potential on the Irish front, but also on an EU basis. And secondly, we bought the Mobeus VCT business, fantastic business, which we've combined with our Barronsmead VCT business. So we're now the second largest VCT manager in the UK. We've got two great teams, high performing funds and products within that area. And it's also in a high margin business. So again, a really high quality business, adding another quality angle to our AUM here at Gresham House.
All right, Kevin, thank you very much. Let's bring Tony in, shall we? Because, well, you first unveiled the GH25 5-year strategy just 2 years ago. Can you maybe tell us more about the progress you're making towards achieving the strategic objectives of that?
Yeah, well, so we set that out so that shareholders as well as employees within the business and other stakeholders a good understanding of a framework that we're aiming for within the business. It's like going on a sports pitch, you know where the goal is, and this is our goal over 5 years. We have both strategic and financial ambitions. Last year, clearly the financials have stepped up again as the operational gearing starts kicking in as we scale the business. We've grown our assets under management. It's helped enhance our margin. We've taken our margin from 2 or 3 years ago in the teens to around 33% currently. In addition to that, we've improved our return on capital, as I've mentioned earlier, and that's a very significant ambition to have a 20% plus over the medium term. And we achieved over 30% last year. And of course, that throws out the fact we're generating cash from our business and our shareholders are very ambitious in terms of getting some income. So we've enhanced our dividend and set a policy for that 3x cover over the next 2 or 3 years. We're really very much on track for hitting and hopefully exceeding our GH25 targets. As I said at the start, we're on a journey. Clients like what we're doing, both in terms of investment performance, as well as the fact that we're offering things that are non-financial in their benefits, like sustainability characteristics. So we've got a fantastic team in this business. They know what their goals are. They're hitting them and exceeding them. There's still a long way to go. People are motivated and we're set for fair for the future.
All right. Well, thank you both very much indeed. That's Tony Dalwood there, accompanied by Kevin Acton here on Proactive London from Gresham House.
Good to be here. Thank you.